नमस्कार एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल लर्न एचटीएमएल विद नंदू जाधव। फ्रेंड्स, इन आवर लास्ट वीडियो वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस ऑल द इनपुट कंट्रोल्स अवेलेबल विद एचटीएमएल 4.0। टुडे वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग दिस फॉर्म डिजाइनिंग, दैट मीन्स इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस ऑल एडवांस्ड इनपुट एलिमेंट्स एज वेल एज इनपुट रेस्ट्रिक्शंस provided or introduced in HTML 5.0. So let us start. So advanced input elements are also used to collect information from the user, as well as from using some of these input elements, that some input elements we can also use for the validation purpose also. The first input element is color picker. And this color picker provides user a millions of colors, and he can or she can select any color of his or her choice for the further processing. Its default color is black, and the value can be given by using only hexadecimal number or hexadecimal notations, that are the 7-digit number. From that 7, the first one is hash. If we insert this one, we need to use this syntax, that the input type equal to color. Remember, each and every input control or element must have a name. Here also we require to give a name. If we see this color picker with example, then check here. See here, in this example, two color pickers are used here, and here we see this one, that the this one is the first one, first color picker, and this one is the second color picker. For both color picker, the default value is displayed as a black. Here two color pickers are used to apply, first color picker is used to apply background color of the body to change this background color, and second color picker is used to apply the text color of this web page. Okay, so when you click on this input control or element, then it displays this like control, and from this you can change the colors as per our requirement. Here we can select, we can create any color. That means this color picker give a millions of colors, and user can select any color, any color. Okay, suppose its default value, if we see its default value is black, and when you click on this submit button, then this background color is applied to the whole web page when you click on the submit button. Here also remember, the four color pick colors, default one is also black, so this text will be automatically disappear because its color is also black. Okay, suppose you want to change the four color, then by using this second pick color, you can change this to any color of our choice. See, this one is the color. Here also you can give values for the red, green and blue by direct typing or selecting this one. When you click here also, then the background color is black, and the four color is, that is the magenta color. Okay, if you want to change the background color once again, you can select any color as a background color and then click it, apply to the background color. Okay, so to insert this input control, these input elements, we just require this one, that is the first one here, input type equal to color. And here the name is given by using this ID attribute. For the second one is also input type equal to color, and the name is given as a different name, that is the four color, because this pick color element is used to apply to the four color. Okay. So in this output, when you click on this submit button, here also you can write input type equal to submit or input type equal to button to insert a command button. But here, according to our in HTML 5.0, it provides button tag, and this button tag insert command button on a web page. This button tag is pair tag, and in between opening button and closing button we can give a caption or label for that command button. Here the submit is given as a caption of this command button. When you click, that is here, see, on click, when you click on this button, then this function is called here. Here two variables are used for the storing the color for of both the first pick color and for second pick color. Here the first variable is x, and the value for this back color, that means the first pick color, is assigned to the value x. And after that we can change the background color to the selected color of the first pick color. So where x equal to, that is the script program. This one is the script program specially used to apply how to implement, how to use these selected colors. So this is the example. So here the important one is you can insert the pick color input control by using this input type equal to color with its name. Okay, here also the second is used. So this one is the first input element. Okay, then the second one is a number. As like color, the number is also can be available here ready made. There is no need to type the numbers here. As like as displays in this diagram, see here the select number, here the list is displayed with the provided number. And to insert this input control, the syntax is input type equal to number. You can give also name to this one. And suppose we will see this example. See here select number. That means there is no need to type. You can also type number here. But remember, here the value, if we decrease this one, the minimum value is displayed here as a 1. And if you give, value is given is 6. It's because, see here, it's source code. Here input type equal to number, the name is given as a level, and here the min and max, the minimum value and maximum values are assigned here. So why that the there in this list the maximum value is displayed as a 6 and minimum is displayed as a 1, not a 0. But by default, its value, we can set any value by using this min and max value. Okay, here also some scripting programs are used, because by using this entered number or selected number, that selected numbers, how we can use that selected numbers. So for that, here once again I use this script here, and the value of this number field is assigned to the variable x, and that x value is considered as a heading level 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5 by using this syntax. Here the x means any value that you can select. So why the minimum value is set as a 1 and maximum value is set as a 6. Okay, as per your requirement you can set the value minimum or maximum. Here we need to, I think we will display the heading levels contents, so the minimum and maximum heading level range is 1 to 6. So I set the minimum value is 1 and maximum value is 6. If we set the value as 1, or if we set the value as a 6, and when you click here, then the contents will be changed to heading level 6, because here the 6 number is selected. See here, if you set the value to 1, then it displays the contents in a heading level 1, because the selected number here is 1. Okay, so by using this number input element, we can select any number from the provided list, or we can type the number that are provided in between min and max value. The third input element is URL. This field is used to enter URL when you want to enter a field value as any file value at that time, you need to set this input element. Remember another important thing about the URL, that when you enter the URL and submit the form, then HTML 5.0 or that browser which support HTML 5.0 automatically verify that the entered URL is right or wrong. Okay, and to insert this input control, again input type equal to URL is used. We see the example here. See your example, enter URL of your file. When you click some file name here, see, I type the file name .htm, and when submit, then it shows message that the error, that means the entered URL is not a valid. So please insert valid URL. And so to insert valid URL, just I copy the contents of this file and instead here we paste this and submit. Then see, automatically it submit, then there is no any error will be displayed. That means the entered value in the field URL is validated automatically when you submit this form. For that we use here only input type equal to URL, and here the placeholder is used. That placeholder displays enter a URL, that means it tells the label the, or it tells the user that which type of entry will be made here. Okay, so this one is the third input elements. The next input element is image as a submit button. Here by using submit button, we can submit our form. Instead of that submit button, we can use any image as a graphical submit button image. Okay, and the syntax is here input type equal to image. If we see the example here, here I create a form with single line text box, multi line text box, and here instead of submit button, the image is used as a button, as a submit button. Okay, suppose here I write and submit, then it submit the contents as like a submit button. If you see the source here, the syntax is some different here. Input type equal to image is not only required, but here we need to give the source of that image which you want to use as a submit button. So here src for this image is displayed. We can also control the height and width of that image by using the height and width attribute. Here just I only use width is equal to 100, so it display the content with that the width, that is 100 pixels. Okay, so this one is the another input element. Next one, that is the date element. Here when you want to insert a data in form of a date, any date at that time, but here the not a single line text box is displayed. Instead of that, the date picker interface is displayed. Okay, and to see the, to include this one, input type equal to date syntax is used. And when you want to see, if you want to see this one, click here, see here, select date, and the format is DDMMYYY. When you click this button, then automatically the current date of your system is displayed here. So today is the 28th August, and so displayed, and here you can select any month. When you click here, you can use, see here, the, you can select previous year, you can select next years also. Here 1st January 0001, that means 1st January 1 to 31st December 2,75,760 year is any is a considered as a valid date. So remember, you can set to any here by using any, and you can directly type here. Here also you can type, suppose today is 29, month is suppose 28, then you can type, or you can select here that is the, and you can submit the contents. So there is no need to type, just you can click here and need to select month, year and date. So for this purpose, actually this date input control is used. Here also only input type equal to date. Here also required a name for the further processing. So you can use here name attribute. Next input element is email. It defines field for email address. Previously we use in HTML 4.0, we use or we provide only single and text box to enter email address. Here also, instead of that text box, like that text box, this email input element is provided in HTML 5.0. Here also, when you enter any email address in that field, HTML 5.0 supported browser validate it automatically that the entered email address is valid or not. This one is the most important one, that the new advanced feature provided in HTML 5.0. So this one is the important one. And suppose you want to give multiple email addresses in that single line text box in that field, at that time you need to use multiple attribute along with, okay. The syntax for this one is input type equal to email. If we see the example, we practically will see here, enter your email address. Suppose we insert something like this one and submit, then it give message, please include @ in email address. Okay, suppose you give @ symbol and something and submit, here also the submission. Once again, suppose we insert invalid email address, then it gives also submit. It requires the following contents after the @ symbol. So here you can use any valid email address. To insert multiple, you need to use multiple attribute. Here, see, I entered my email address here and submit. It should not contain a symbol. We will check first its code, there multiple attribute is used or not. Then we will check once again. No, input type equal to email. If we use multiple, at that time you can enter an email, and to use this you need to input type equal to email, and then after that there we require multiple. And when you use multiple, here we can give a multiple email address at a glance while submitting this field. Okay, this one is the email. Okay, so next one, that the date time local. That means in the previous one, here, see here, in this date only date is selected, not a time. But in the next input element, that is in the date time element, we can select, we can enter date as well as time also. First thing, we can insert date and time. The second important one, that it represent a control for setting the element value to a string representing a local date and time with no time zone information. Here no time zone will be displayed. And to insert this input element, you need to use input type equal to date time hyphen local. For example, we will see practically here. See here, select date and time. Here the date format is same as given, and here there is a space to enter a time. Click here, then we can select here date, time, year. That's a date, month, year, and here from that we can select time. Suppose time is 60-20. You can select 60-20. Suppose today is 31st, you can select and then you can submit. Okay, so using this input element, we can enter or we can select date as well as time. Okay, so if we check the source code, there is a simple input type equal to date time hyphen local. Here also the name is required for the further processing when you want to submit the contents for the further processing. Then the next one is month. We can select month with year by using this input element. Okay, and syntax for this one is input type equal to month. See the example here, that the month, select month, and here also though two spaces are available. Let's check here, after clicking we will see here January automatically is year will be displayed here. You can change, you can directly type June, July, August, September, November. You can just select by typing the initial character, okay, or you can select here any, so you can submit. So this input element display the month with year, okay, and here the syntax is same, the input type equal to month. Okay, then the next input element is week. Just when you want to enter a number of week, at that time you need to set this input element, and these week numbers are provided with the ISO 8061, and there are normally 1 to 53 weeks in a year. Maximum time it displays 52, but sometime there may be a 53 weeks. Okay, so we can select the week by using this input element. See here, this year there are 53 weeks. I think we will check here. See here, so current week number is a 35. If we check, see here, there are 53 week in this year 2020. That means here when you want to insert a week number, at that time you need to use this input element, that the input type equal to week. Okay, then the next input element is range. When you want to give any value, that means there is no any perfect value, there is no need to give the exact number, or exact number is not important here. Just at that time you can set the input element as a range. Okay, this default range is 0 to 100, and you can change this range by using minimum and maximum attributes of input tag. The syntax is input type equal to range. See the example here. In this example, I used two range format here. This one is the range 1 and this is the range 2. Specially this range 2 is used to apply heading level effect. So the value for this one is, I set to 1 to 6 here. First we will check the code, source code. See here, the first heading level. So input type, first range, the range, that the input type equal to range. ID is name is given as the range. And minimum value is set here as a 0 and maximum value is set as a 500. And for the second range, see here, input type equal to range, and minimum is set as a 1, not a 0, and maximum set as a 6. I already tell you that this range 2 is used for the heading level purpose. That means using this value, we can also change the heading levels by using this within the scripting language. Here also the value for both are displayed here. First we will click here, change, we will change this one, and then click. See here, your selected range 1 value is 430 and your selected range value for heading level, that the second range, is 5. So it displays the heading level 5. Okay, if we change to heading level 2, or if we set the value its minimum and click, then it tells your selected range value for the one is 24 and second one, for the second range there is a 2, so it display the contents with heading level 2. Okay, if we set the value as a 1 here, as a 500, see here your selected range 1 value is 500, your selected range value for heading level is 1, that is a heading level 1 is be did. That means as like number here also, we can collect the selected range value for the further processing, and for that once again we will come here, that is the name is given to both range input elements, and this value is collected to the variable y and to variable x, and after that these are printed at a particular location. Okay, so this one is the range value. Here we will discuss all these things in JavaScript. When we start JavaScript, after this we will start the JavaScripting. At that time we will discuss all these elements, all the contents of the scripting. But just remember, these values can be used for the further processing. Next input element is file. In HTML 4.0 there was also file. Here also the file, it attached the file with the form, and to attach this any file, any kind of file, HTML provide or browser provide a browse button or choose file button. Okay, see example. See here, select file. In this is the Google Chrome browser. If we open within the Internet Explorer or within the Microsoft Edge, there browse button, browse labeled button will be displayed to select the file. Here in Chrome it displays choose file. When you click here, see no file chosen, and to choose the file you can select, or you can click here choose file. Then you need to select any file that we want to attach. So open, automatically it displays that this file is attached. When you submit this form, according to the further processing, it will be processed or stored at a particular location. And for this, we need to just use input type equal to file. Here also name is must when you want to process the contents. Next input element is search. The search field is like a text field, that means single line text box. And to include this one, you need to use input type equal to search. There is a little difference I observed in single line text box and in search input control, that we will see here. Here search field, when you click here and type something to search, at that time here the close button is appear to the single line text box. There no any close button will be available, and when you click here and type escape key, it automatically remove all the contents. Actually this is these two differences I noticed while reading some material regarding this search. But I think as per the look or appearance of search input control and single line text box, there are same, there is similarity. When you click and submit, then it submit in the all the inserted contents in the search list. Okay, and here to include this input type equal to search. Another important thing here, that when you want to add the contents in search list. When you want to search the contents, you must need to give a name to this input control, and its default name and maximum time the name provided to this field or to this input element is Q. Okay. Then next one, that is the telephone number, like a single and text box, but here you can collect telephone numbers or phone numbers by using this input field. Syntax is input type equal to tel. Okay, here in this example, see here, enter telephone number. Suppose I type telephone number, you can type and submit here, but here is some error, some restriction. Please match the requested format, because this error is displayed because I set a pattern to this input field, and the pattern here is 0 to 9 number, nearly 4 digits requires. After that they require a hyphen, then after that they require 0 to 9 numbers, 6 digits. Okay, so this message will be displayed. So to add a perfect entry, you need to firstly 4 digit from 0 to 9 number, then there is a hyphen, then 6, then you can submit it. Okay, if we submit without then it display the error. Okay, so it requires perfect displayed format. Here also we requires another digit, then you can submit it. So it requires a pattern input restriction is used here, so you need to use the pattern, else it display a message. So this one is the last one, 30 numbers, advanced input elements provided with HTML5. The input restrictions, that input restrictions are also provided in HTML 5.0. The first one is disabled, that specifies the input field should be disabled. That means user can't edit this one. See here, name of the institute, here is written my college name. Here you cannot change, you cannot type, just you can only submit. So this input field is disabled. So if we see the code here, see here, input type equal to text, that is single and text box used. Size attribute is used to control the width, here the 45 size used, and value I give the default value here, my college name, and important one, that is the disabled. Here disabled means you, this input field is disabled, user cannot change or edit it. Okay, so this one is the disabled. Second one, that is the min and max. Already we use min and max attribute here. We will also see here, enter your age, and here the minimum value is given as a 16 and maximum value is given as a 20. And if you see the source code, see, enter your age, input type equal to number, minimum is 16, maximum is 20. This minimum and maximum value is set as considering the entered value, the value entered in this field maybe by the 12th standard student. So the value range is set in between 16 to 20. Okay, another one, that is pattern. Already we discussed that pattern. Here also we can check this pattern, telephone number. Already we see this one, we can set the pattern by providing this pattern value. This one also important for the validation purposes. The next one, that is the read only, we can give any value, any field value as a read only. after submission also. Here C class is 12. Here we can just only read, not change, we cannot edit, we cannot delete. Just we can only read and submit the contents. At that time we need to use this, that is the input type equal to text. The type text is the default one, so I not use here type equal to text. It automatically considered as a single and text box, and it is used as read only. Okay, then the next input restriction is placeholders. Already we discussed this placeholder. It gives a label instead of giving label tag or giving any value. Before that input control, you can directly give the placeholder. So this act as a temporary label. See here, enter your gender is a placeholder. See here, input name placeholder, that is enter your gender. This placeholder is displayed here. When you type, then automatically this placeholder will be automatically disappear. Okay, so this one is the placeholder. Another one, that is the required, it indicates the field must be filled, that is the field is compulsory. Okay, if we see the example here also, 11th result passed or promoted. Okay, so here if we not fill the contents and submit, then it gives please fill out this field. That means this field is a compulsory and we need to fill this one. Okay, then it submit. Here also we need to use CS here, input required. Okay, the required means compulsory field. Another one, that is the autocomplete, and the value for this autocomplete is set as a on or a off. When you click here, we will see the autocomplete percentage. See here, percentage. The here, if we see the source code, the autocomplete value is set as a on. That means when you insert any value here, see here 68, 78, 70, my name 56, 44. Instead of, suppose I write 11 and submit, it automatically insert in that list. Okay, if I want to see 1111 and submit, it's submitted. And when you type once again that one, it automatically displays. This automatically displays because autocomplete is set as a on. When you set off, then there the no list will be displayed here. Okay, this one is the autocomplete on. Okay, then the next one, that is autofocus. That means when there are multiple fields and when you want to set the focus when the page is loaded in the web browser to particular field, at that time you can use this attribute of input or that input control. See here, autofocus. See here, his autofocus is used here and cursor is automatically placed in the hobby. There rest of informations are available. This one is the 7 number field, but automatically the cursor is focused directly in this hobby, that means in autofocus contents. Okay, so for this you need to use here, see here, input autofocus. Just you need to use autofocus. It set the default or the first inserted value. Okay, then and next one, that the height and width, you can control the height and width. Specially used input type equal to image, already we use here. See, we will once again here, this image is used as a submit button, and I control the height and width by using height equal to 50 and width equal to 50. See here, input type equal to image, SRC equal to, I use another image, and I control the image submit button image by using this height and width attribute. Okay, so we can control the height and width attribute. And last one, that is the multiple, it allows to enter or insert multiple values, specially used for email and file inputs. We will see here. I think I design the multiple here. So first I write my email address here. Suppose we will see submit no gmail.com. Then suppose you want to use another one, so give comma and aaa@gmail.com. At that time you can submit. See here. So here this multiple attribute, see here, input type equal to email, multiple gives to enter a multiple values in that field. Okay, so this one is the last input restriction provided in HTML 5.0. So thank you students for watching my video. Today we complete form designing in HTML 5.0. In our next video we will going to start CSS. In between CSS and this form designing, I will upload how to insert tables on a web page, because tables are also important for us. So table designing in HTML, as well as hyperlinks are also important one. So hyperlinks as well as images on a web page. So these three videos will be uploaded. So to watch this all, please subscribe my channel and keep in touch. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.